Modern, one of the best formats in Magic the Gathering, once they banned KCI, a format that allows for high-level competitive play, but also for players to develop and stick with their favorite decks and still be able to pilot them to success, once KCI is banned. And the format is ever-evolving with each new set as well. Ravnica Allegiance will soon dip its proverbial toes into the modern card pool. And when that happens, what will be the cards most likely to see play and have an impact on the modern format? None, so long as KCI is not banned, as there is no reason to play anything else, nor will you face anything else. The format will spiral downwards into oblivion, consuming itself like a twisted Ouroboros snake, eating its own tail until nothing remains but the vile, splattered corpse of the format we once all loved. This is what you have wrought by not banning KCI, Wizards of the Coast, Aaron Forsyth, and Gavin Verhey. This is what you have wrought, and your legacy for allowing this atrocity will echo throughout generations to come. But, assuming that KCI does get banned soon, presented here are the top 5 cards from Ravnica Allegiance, most likely to see play and make an impact in Modern. Ban KCI. Before we begin, I have an honorable mention and, I suspect, a bit of a controversial one. Sphinx of Foresight is a card getting incredible hype in the community already, but while I admit it is cool and interesting and, like many cards that ultimately fail to make an impact, has potential, many Magic the Gathering players preemptively disagree with me. I just don't think it's going to get there, but for an excellent counter-argument, the legendary professional Magic player Ben Friedman did an insightful and extremely well-written write-up of Sphinx of Foresight already, and I will link that article in this video's description, and I encourage you to go read it and consider. I do disagree with Mr. Friedman on Sphinx's potential success in Modern. But hey, Ben Friedman is just one of the greatest players of Magic the Gathering in the world. And my greatest competitive accomplishment was winning Game Day Dark Ascension. So there is a reasonable chance his evaluation is superior to my own. That being said, Sphinx of Foresight is a 2 and 2 blue mana for a 4/4 flying Sphinx that reads, you may reveal this card from your opening hand. If you do, scry 3 at the beginning of your first upkeep. At the beginning of your upkeep, scry 1. Opening hand cards are neat little things, aren't they? Like the Phyrexian Chancellors, the Ley Lines, and Gemstone Caverns. They carry with them the possibility of getting something for nothing. And what Magic player doesn't love value like that. Again, I do not think this card is totally bad. Some of Sphinx's best uses are going to be in modern combo decks, where players can use it to put their pieces together while also possibly doubling as a beater with reasonable evasion. Beyond that, the main uptick of this card is to help us dig for needed cards, especially sideboard hosers we switched in. But at the end of the day, I just don't think this card has enough to get there. Paying 4 mana for a 4/4 flyer is not what you want to be doing in modern. We already have cards like Search for Ascanta, which handle our scrying needs, and quite frankly, do so better and for less. The card teases us with this idea of getting something for nothing, but at the end of the day, with all due respect to those excited about this card, I feel modern is just not going to have much use for it. Nonetheless, Scry 3 is incredibly powerful, and considering there are modern decks that run cards like Serum Powder, perhaps including a card that powerful when in your opening hand, though a dud when outside of it, makes more sense than I am giving it credit for. Only time will tell, but I am still not optimistic. So what cards do I feel will certainly make an impact in Modern and see play? Well, coming in at number 5 is a Renegade looking to stop some of our out-of-control Modern shenanigans. And that card is Lavinia, Azurius Renegade. Lavinia is 1 white and 1 blue for a 2/2 legendary human soldier. Again with the humans. I am so sick of modern humans that I just want to return to Lorwyn because it's a plane with no humans on it. Give it a rest already, R&D. Lavinia reads, each opponent can't cast non-creature spells with converted mana cost greater than the number of lands that player controls. Whenever an opponent casts a spell, if no mana was spent to cast it, counter that spell. Yes, yes, cue the tired cliche of Tron Killer, but Tron Killer. This hits turn three Karns, Ugins, All is Dust, and other out-of-control, non-creature spells. Stop Splice onto Nourishing Shoal, or any attempts to get some ridiculous win con through the breach early. Living End decks don't like this card, neither does Ad Nauseam. Sadly, it does nothing against the number one offender right now, KCI. Hopefully, an incoming ban will take care of that miserable deck, and Lavinia will then find a nice home among her own cons. Or perhaps just in many a sideboard in Modern. Coming in at number four is an almost reprint from original Return to Ravnica block. Has this card got legs in Modern? Yes, quite literally, as my number four pick is Deputy of Detention. Deputy of Detention is a 1/3 Vedalken Wizard for one and a blue and a white. When Deputy of Detention enters the battlefield, exile target non-land permanent and opponent controls and all other non-land permanents that player controls with the same name as that permanent until Deputy of Detention leaves the battlefield. So yeah, this is Detention Sphere on legs. Long, sexy 1/3 legs. The only difference is that Deputy cannot target your own permanents and must instead target those of an opponent, but otherwise this is Detention Sphere. What's the advantage to being a creature, you might ask? Doesn't that just mean it is more likely to die to removal? Yes, but in this case it's better to be the creature, because by being a creature this becomes extremely viable in Court of Calling and Collected Company decks. The ability to, at instant speed, Cord or Coco for a Deputy of Detention is going to be what puts this over the top. Yes, it is more perilous than an enchantment, but being a creature that can be tutored at instant speed makes it far more beneficial by far. It's the sort of trade-off we want. Next up at number three is an extremely interesting card just oozing with potential. It's not as strong as its closest comparison, but it absolutely can blow into Modern and take hold before you have a chance to sneeze. That card is Prime Speaker Vanifar. Prime Speaker Vanifar is a 2/4 Elf Ooze Wizard with a very birthing pod-like ability. Tap to sacrifice another creature, search your library for a creature card with converted mana cost equal to 1, plus the sacrificed creature's converted mana cost, put that card onto the battlefield, then shuffle your library. Activate this ability only anytime you could cast a sorcery. This too is birthing pod on legs, not legs so much as a slimy, amoeba-like blob. But nonetheless, Birthing Pod was banned in Modern for good reason, and now we have it back. Only in creature form, and with the very minor drawback that it cannot be activated the turn it comes into play. I think this is strong enough to bring Kiki-core decks back from the brink, letting us devise strategies to Vanifar into cards like Deceiver Exarch, and ultimately Restoration Angel and Kiki-Jiki Mirror Breaker to combo off for the win, all while using the classic Kiki-core shell as a tool kit to get us there. There's of course the big drawback that without being able to trade life for Phyrexian mana, the full 4 mana CMC is also relevant. So the question is, has R&D powered this down enough to make it fair in Modern? Is it still far too powerful for Modern? Or has it been nerfed too hard, making it not viable in Modern? I think they hit that sweet spot right in the middle. It's extremely good, but not overwhelmingly so, and that is why it is my solid number 3 pick. As we approach my number 1 and number 2 picks, I had to make a decision. Do I order these choices logically, like a blue player, or emotionally, like a red? There is zero doubt in my mind that number 2 will see play, whereas number 1 is a bit of an impulsive pick. Nevertheless, since both cards are red, I followed my mountainous heart and threw logic to the wind. Number 2 will absolutely see play in Modern, and that card is Skewer the Critics. More than one fan said they were surprised that Wizards of the Coast didn't send me, former recipient of both Tolarian Scholar and Refuse to Cooperate, this card as a preview.
That's a pretty good card to give someone you feel is a difficult or hard to work with.
Instead, they made amends by letting me preview a new Domri, which, while he won't have a home in Modern, did lead to an interesting visit from his legal raiders. And if you have not seen my Office Hours skit that card inspired, take a moment to follow the top link in the credits and do so now. But Skewer the Critics will see play in Burn without a doubt. It will see play in Standard. It will see play in Pauper. It will see play in just about everywhere, including Legacy, and yes, for the purposes of this list, Modern. It's a lightning bolt. It beats, in my opinion, cards like Rift Bolt and even Lava Spike in Modern Burn, especially Modern Mono Red Burn. It might as well just be another set of lightning bolts. In fact, I think we are up to, what, 20 lightning bolts in Modern now? 24? That's a deck I want to build. But even in decks that actually win consistently, Skewer the Critics has a home and will ensure that Modern Burn just got a little better than before, and it was already pretty good. So what is the number one card from Ravnica Allegiance to see play and have a meaningful impact in Modern? Skewer the Critics will absolutely see play in Modern, but just as an additional lightning bolt in an established deck. Boring! No, for number one, I follow my fiery impulse and passion and creativity. It's a card I am beyond excited about, with potential to break the format wide open once KCI is banned. And that card, wait for it, is Electro Dominance. No, really, this is number one, by far. Electro Dominance is 2 red mana and X for an instant that reads, Electro Dominance deals X damage to any target. You may cast a card with converted mana cost X or less from your hand without paying its mana cost. Basically, we turn a bunch of little lightnings into one big lightning, and I honestly can say I don't see a single other card from all of Ravnica Allegiance that is more made for Modern impact than this. The shenanigans it enables are too numerous to even list in this video. Use it to cheat out cards like Living End and Lotus Bloom. Cast it for one. Bolt the Bird and then Ancestral Visions? Yes, please. Or just zero and restore balance, wiping your opponent's board if they start to go off early. In addition to allowing for those early Living Ends to be fired off, decks like Skred are going to become a much more powerful one. And I don't doubt we will see the emergence of a solid red-blue counterbalance build. Electro Dominance even allows for things like an instant speed Thoughtseize, and on and on. This is a card that is beyond pushed. It is absolutely and overwhelmingly my number one pick for Modern from Ravnica Allegiance. But now I want to hear from you. What cards from Ravnica Allegiance do you think will see play in Modern and why? Let me know in the comments below. And remember, Ravnica Allegiance pre-release is just around the corner, and pre-release is one of the best events to play at your local game store for players new and old. If you want a refresher course on how exactly to build a sealed deck for pre-release, check out my video on that topic here, or pass it along to a friend who might be going to their local game store for pre-release for the first time. But either way, I hope to see them and you at Ravnica Allegiance pre-release in a few days. And this program was made possible thanks to a sponsorship from Card Kingdom, as well as the Patreon support of viewers such as you. So thank you.